Hello, Serge here from the back porch. We have a statement from Kevin McCarthy that was in the blog on that day where we had a lot of conversations about where's the mitt and where's the tree and trying to swing vertical. And he made a bunch of nice comments about the value of the blogs to him and everything else. And I think that might be nice just to let you all know what I know most of you are. Why you're here on these blogs because of what Kevin's going to say in a minute. But it also triggered another very important point for me to bring up about swinging a golf club. So I'm going to read the whole thing and make some comments on what he said, and then especially about what we're going to get today as our thought for the day, so to speak, on this daily of improving our golf swing. Kevin McCarthy said, "Serge, I can only pray that these are recorded and will be available for eons. You are our Bob Hope, Johnny Carson, and any other icon. You are so on topic for us. The other day you mentioned having to have just enough turn to make the swing work, and it was just right on target for me. I find just about every day's topics to catch my interest, just as today's. I find that when I incorporate each topic, I pull the puzzle together." I really like that. I pulled the puzzle together. This is somewhat of a puzzle, but the key is to get it all laid out there and know exactly what it looks like. "I have always said this is a very easy swing. I just try and make it harder from all the bad things I've learned before. Thanks so much." So, yes, it is a very easy swing. It's the body-friendly swing also. And to me, I've stated it a number of times, and that where do I get all my ideas for these daily blogs? I get them from you. I get them from the daily blogs. I get all these ideas for the daily videos from the daily blogs. I get them from all the lessons I give students, including when I teach DJ. As you know, many times I've told you about the things I worked on with him. And so the thing is getting back to me, is I try to go out and play a few holes, or at least 9 holes as often as I can, to try to keep my swing correct, because when I make swings here, I want to be as swing surgeon, swing correct as I can be in demonstrating to all of you in the daily videos. So I need to keep my swing up, never mind the fact that it's because I want to be the best I can be, just as you all are, and that's why you're listening to these. But I think the topic I really want to raise now is that you've heard me say many, many times, especially when somebody asks, should I take a practice swing? Yes, if you want to take a practice swing, that's fine with me, but you must make a good practice swing. Perfect practice makes perfect. That means you must have a complete setup from a good grip, stance, posture, alignment, and then make a perfect swing. You don't have to swing it full bore, but you have to swing it with enough muscle tone and enough muscle engagement to make sure that you maintain your knees. You're going to have that little bit of turn, the exact amount you want to the toe line, and swing through, up, finish, recoil, and relax. And when you have the swing you want, you say, that's it. What you're saying is, that's the feel I want to hit this golf shot. And naturally, if you were trying to hit a golf shot, like working the ball or whatever, you should be in the setup and the swing that will create the swing that will give you the shot shape you want, or the shot height, whether it be higher or lower or whatever. You must do it exactly as you want. And when you get that feeling, that's what you say. That's the feeling. Then you step up and you swing the feel. Now, I've said that 1,000 times, but I think I'm going to add another little element to it that I've said a few times, I think, but not emphasize it that much. I think the whole thing comes down to a point I call knowing your place in space. You have to build up these images and these senses, like I did a couple days ago with the catches into the catches mitt in the tree, up the tree where I had the flower pot with the reflector in there, and as an imagery of a tree. You can use that on a tree as we hit it and ricochet up there. So I'm learning all these places. One of the most important places that I think that I deal with is what I call knowing my place in space for my backswing and then my forward swing. So if I stand there and get in my posture, this is point A for my backswing, and this is point B for my forward swing. So if I stand from this position, I'm up here like this, there's my backswing, and if I have the club in my hands, if you see me demonstrate a few times, I could drop the club and it would hit right in the center, that fleshy part of my shoulder. So if I go like this, I'm gonna just take this and go there it is, boom. And then if I get back on this side and I go like this and I come down and up and get there it is in that same fleshy part on the other side. So I learned those two places in space. And And so they're in space right here when I want to swing. Naturally, if I'm going to hit different types of shots, that might change a little bit, but I'm always knowing where point A to point B is, and as well as having these visual images in my mind, whether they be the catcher's mitt, a tree, or the reflector, or in some cases, maybe even feel like there's a wall here, and I'm just going to hit the wall and slide right on up the wall to my finish. There's a wall right here. Engage your mind. Remember, there's no such thing as muscle memory. It's mental memory. Your mind moves, makes everything happen. It moves the correct muscles the way you want them to move, or they must move to build a swing and move in the way you want it to move. And ultimately, as I've said a few times, and I'll say it again, the whole key is I must swing the club. The club does not swing me. This club shouldn't do anything that I don't want it to do, or and it's for yourself, what you don't want it to do. And therefore, it must do what you want it to do. And the only way is you have to know what you want to do. And in the end, trying to do it mentally, connecting dots throughout the swing doesn't work. It's feelings. We swing by feelings. If you've ever been around a pro working with a good player, what do you hear? They change technique, they change positions into feel. What are you feeling? Oh, I'm feeling that this over here, and I'm feeling this over there. You have to awaken your mind into the senses. The more senses you use, the more powerful the feedback. The more powerful the feedback, the quicker the learning experience. Engage your mind. Sense in terms of seeing in your mind and feeling what your body has to do to make the club do what you want it to do. Okay? Well, that's it for the search for today, and I'll be talking to you all again soon.